In this video, we are going to investigate a very interesting link between Pythagoras triplets and the largest circle that fits inside each triplet. Here we have the simplest triplet. The circle touches the sides of the triangle 3x4x5. Can you estimate the size of the radius? Stop the video here and make a guess. The circle with radius r divides the sides of the triangle like this. The interesting thing and what I need you to notice is that if we draw a line from the center of this circle to the top vertex, this will divide the top quadrilateral into two equal triangles. That's right, both are right angle triangles with two equal lengths. So the missing length must be the same, 3 minus r and 4 minus r. These two lengths add up to 5. Solving the equation for r, we end up with radius equals 1. Similarly, we can use the next Pythagorean triplet, a triangle with sides 5, 12, 13. The sides 5 minus r and 12 minus r make up for the hypotenuse, length 13. Solving the equation, we end up with the value of r equals 2. Interesting. And again, the third Pythagorean triplet will fit a circle with radius 3. So, could we perhaps use this link to find the next Pythagorean triplet? Notice that the three red dashed lines divide our triangle ABC into three right angle triangles with height, the radius, and base, the sides A, B, and C. The red triangle has an area a half of A times R. The blue triangle has an area a half BR and the green a half CR. They add up to the area of the big triangle, a half of A times B. Cancelling the fractions, we can see that the radius is the quotient between the product of the short sides and the sum of the three sides of our triplet. To find our next triplet, we know that the shortest side is going to be 9. We explained this in our previous video, Pythagorean triplets. On that video, we figured out that we always, always can make a triplet by using an odd number as the shortest side. The other two sides are consecutive numbers. We want the radius of the circle to be 4. Replacing these values into our equation and solving for m, we can figure out the next triplet. Voila, our next triplet. If you enjoyed this video, subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell to receive updates. Leave your comments and give us a thumbs up so that other people can benefit from these videos.